Where's the live stream? On YouTube? put together a nice event for you where you get to meet and hopefully hear as well some of the experiences that the two voice actors from Encanto have. They worked in many productions, including Narcos, The Greatest Showman, and many others that I don't remember right now. But yeah, thank you so much for coming out, and they'll be here in a second.
They're both incredibly talented actors, singers, and two of your favorite faces from a very popular Oscar award-winning production. So, Carlos?
Yeah, without further ado, let's introduce Carolina Gaitan and Mauricio Castillo.
That I was going to be able to hold my brother's hand And he looked exactly like me, and he would love Disney movies just like I did. So he would repeat Gaston's and Manhattan's and Genie's lines. Well, I would repeat Belle's, Alice's, and Jasmine's. And then when I was 7, we decided to move to the capital of Colombia, which is Bogota. And when I was 14, my parents started having a lot of economic struggles. So I started thinking, what can I do in order to help my parents to pay my school? So I started to sell arepas, like in Encanto, yeah. And it wasn't a bad business at all. Kids from other schools would come to my house and buy 10, 20, 30 arepas. And yeah, I was able to pay for my tuition fee. When I was selling the last arepa, I started singing to my friends because they will always ask me to sing, and that's what I would do. After graduation, I was thinking, what am I gonna do since I cannot sell more arepas because I don't have the school for selling arepas? So I decided to, even though I wasn't the money to pay for going to college, I decided to go and join my friends during breaks in between classes and being there with them and singing for them. And one of these days, a friend asked me, Caro, do you know about this singing contest that is coming to Colombia called Pop Stars? And I was like, I have no idea. I didn't even know it was a reality show for that moment. And I was like, okay, since we both sing, and this is this singing contest, let's go and have fun. And I decided to go, and when I arrived, I see this line, this huge line, and I asked for a number, and they say, okay, this is your number, it is 1,387. Oh my God, I thought, okay, so if this is just Bogota, what about Colombia? Maybe I am one in 7,000 girls around Colombia dreaming with the same thing, becoming a singer. I thought, too many. Lines, singing. So, anyways, five girls, okay, with a better song? Yeah, or whatever. So five girls were chosen, and one of these girls would be me. And I thought, even though I was one in 7,000, there would always be a lot of competition, always. But there would always be not only a place for us, but a place made for us. So, yeah, during concerts and during tourings and during CD recordings, I thought, maybe now I have money enough to pay for my first semester of college, because I really wanted to live this experience that you're having, guys, right now. So, yeah, I quit the group and I enrolled to the Jorge Tadeo University, and I studied communication science. And I wasn't only studying because I had to work as well, so I was studying Monday to Friday. In the afternoons, I was working at a radio station, and on weekends, I was working already presenting a 4 hours long TV live show. It was really long, but it was a really good experience to start. And then during this, I was thinking, what about acting? I really want to be an actress, but I didn't know how to do it. So there's this, my pop star director called me. I thought they were hating me because I quit the group, but no, I don't know why. They wasn't hating me, and he tells me that there's this audition because they were looking for a group amongst around 400 people to win a scholarship at an acting school. And I thought, finally, I have a chance to study acting. I remember that I went to this audition, and I've never felt so confident and happy, and I've never felt that I was flying so high, right there from a chair in front of a teacher doing my performance that was monologue. And I decided I not only wanted to study there, but I wanted to study. I went to New York and I studied at the Lee Strasberg Theater and Film Institute. I studied the method acting, and then I studied my certificate as well. I didn't want back then, and I still don't want today, to stop learning, to stop studying, to stop feeling like I am flying while I am performing. So, yeah. none of the four girls of my family decided to follow my father's footsteps, but my brother. So he was studying, and then one day, right before his graduation, the school gave him an airplane with a gas leak. And it took me a long time to understand that I hadn't lost a brother, but I won a huge angel with an immense wings. Life tests. How many life tests do we have to overcome to become stronger human beings? How many life tests do we have to overcome to become a better actors, professionals, performers, even artists? The answer is many.
Teresa, yo lo único que quiero es que terminemos esto rápido y nos volvamos para Colombia.
Los que necesitan nuestra ayuda.
Eso no le mueve ningún lado, humano.
One of the friends that I met in the singing contest, like, Caro. What? Hi! What are you doing here? No, what are you doing here? No, no, I'm studying audition something. What about you? No, I'm promoting this major film called Terminator Dark Fate. Do you want to come to my class? Yeah, come. So she ended coming up to my class, and when we were going to say goodbye, she's like, Cara, do you know about this Encanto casting, Disney casting? No, I have no idea. I think it's a good opportunity for you since they're looking for Latino actors and singers. You should go. So she sent me all the info, and the week later, I am having my first in-person casting at the Disney Studios in Burbank, California. So I wanted to I remember that I rehearsed this song, I don't know if you know it, Don't Rain on My Parade by Barbara Streisand. And I arrived, and then James Parer, the casting director, is like, are you sure? Are you gonna sing that song? I was like, not anymore, but no, yeah, I'm ready. And then she says, do you mind if I shut my eyes? Because I really want to be focused on your voice. And I had this huge performance that I wanted to do. I was like, okay. But anyways, I did my performance, and then I start seeing her that she's peeking through her fingers, and at the end she's clapping, and I was like, maybe I did all right? Do you think so? But I was trying to calm myself, because it is always almost a no. 1, 2, 3, 4 months of absolute silence. And then she calls me, Cara, you're gonna meet the director, so you're gonna have a callback. So I prepared this huge speech talking about my work in Colombia, my characters, my songs, my music, and then they're like, they didn't want to hear any of those. They just wanted to know about myself, about my parents, about my family flying over the jungle, about my brother that now is my angel. And this takes me to the first part of this talk, when I was telling you that we always think that we can introduce ourselves through our gifts, our talents, our jobs. And definitely they are really important, since they could change not only your reality, but others' reality. But there are no gifts, there are no talents without a human, a real human being behind. So if you ask me, guys, after 1, 2, 3, 4 months of absolute silence, they finally call me and they tell me, Caro, you're gonna be Pepa Madrigal in Encanto. I don't know if there is a formula for succeed, for being successful, or for being chosen for the characters that we want to perform. But I know that there are 4 words that could be vital in any project that we do. And there are purpose. Why do we do what we do? This question leads us to our life mission. And knowing it, we can be coherent with our actions as well. Passion. Without it, our hearts won't beat as much with what we do. And with it, I mean, everything is possible. I really feel that whenever we feel passion, we definitely feel that we are capable. And capabilities are even bigger when they are aligned with knowledge, definitely. And preparation. Yeah, what better feeling than feeling ready when the moment comes? Nothing. So it's amazing to just continue working and working and learning. This is the best feeling ever. And the last one, guys, is persistence. Having the work in their hands is only because, yeah, whenever you feel that loss or failure or negatives are the end, or no's, these no's are actually the bricks that make up a huge building called yes. Thank you very much. Oh.
composer, trombonist.
Do you want this microphone?
Here. Yeah,
I'm gonna turn it off.
Okay. Mauricio Castillo, singer, actor, composer, trombonist, arranger, musical producer, with the dream to communicate through the arts. Perhaps you wonder why I do so many things. Some of those I learned because of a genuine desire, and others are a combination of pleasure and necessity. As a necessity, because I have the dream to record some ideas, for example, to put some music and record it. And the producer said, that's not the way, it will not sound good enough. And so I had to learn how to put out my ideas into the air, I grew up between two neighborhoods. You may also wonder why. Because one was under construction and the other was already built. And that's what I want to talk about today, to build things. I remember my parents and my neighborhood and my neighbors. And putting brick after brick in order to have a wall done. So let me share some pictures. Prado Sur. This is my first neighbor, Prado Sur. Okay. About construction, that exercise, that daily practice that we see every day and inhabit our lives in as constant movement, okay? And my first neighborhood is called Middle on the South, Proud of the Services, okay? In Cali, Colombia. I witnessed its construction, like I said. My father, together with the neighborhood, with the neighbors, had to lay the house and pipes that carried the water to the houses, long stretches, because for the city, the neighborhood simply did not exist, never in the map. So, and we didn't have any kind of like help from the city, to be. The land was bought completely legal, but they had no grants. The first night, my father has to sleep with a bunch of cake, a flashing light, and a machete to defend the land from invaders. He had to stop studying. I saw him graduate from the university years before. The second neighborhood where I grew is called Christopher Columbus. In that neighborhood, my grandparents and my uncle lived in a house where music and love were everywhere. I got there because in Prado del Sur, we had a serious problem. There was a sewage canal, and every time it rained, it overflowed. Okay. My house was made of wood. The floor was made of dirt. My father was a school teacher at that time, and he had to stay alone in the house, removing the roof so that the floor made of dirt could dry out. It's not an easy task. I was pretty small, and I thought I had a pool inside of my house, But I couldn't use it. Okay, let's talk about my family composition. I grew up with my parents and Maribel. Close to your home, but Maribel is her name. Thank you.
Maribel, my other sisters. 8 years after I was born, my second sister, May, arrived. We had a beautiful childhood with pure nature, and we shared a lot. We always had a good relationship with each other, okay? Living in the neighborhood was complicated, you know? No resources at all. We found conflicting people. But there's people that were very respectful. And from the two types, we learned. We understood about life and surroundings. The importance of being around by good people, or at least wise people, because it's more about focusing on the things that help you grow as individual and that help increase the people that share by your side. Let me give you an example. Once, when I was 13 or 14 years old, I was playing with a friend, and I need to peel a huge hard-skinned orange that a neighbor had given me. I was playing soccer, so I was so thirsty and excited. And we tried to put it. I need to write it down because I will. You will figure it out. And I asked my friend if he had something to cut the orange with. And he took out a knife. And I tried to cut it, but the knife had almost no edge, you know? And I was a student at a school where there was access to a workshop with a sharpener or electric knife, an emery. And I told him that maybe we could find a way to get to the machine and sharpen it. We were silent for a while. I was so naive to bring a weapon to the to school. We were silent. And I was thinking about how to ask permission at the school. Instead, he asked me if the school was without guards. I mean, how many guards were there now? Unfortunately, he was thinking about how to steal the machine. Then you realize that we are not in the same initial system. Let's talk about science a little bit with this example to understand initial system. The Earth has a speed of rotation of 761 miles per hour, like here in Connecticut. In Ecuador, it's like 1,000. Don't get confused. It is constant. That's why we don't know, why we don't feel it. Only if we go, for example, in a car, we will feel the inertia, right? If you're inside of a car traveling at a constant speed, and you throw a ball of paper off your cell phone, like your cell phone off, it will fall in your hand, right? But if you do the same to the window, you're gonna lose it, right? Maybe you will get in trouble because you're going to hit the one waiting for the bus. Maybe. Initial system also exists between people who come together through their habits. So please check very carefully in what kind of initial system you are, and if it's honor 100% the people who want the best for you. Okay? Your grandmother, your mother, your father, your uncle, your teacher, your best friend, your partner, We are in the need of to constantly check that system, if that system honors what we are and what we need. And just try to see our history as a timeline history that includes our grandfather, our father, mother, and our ancestors. No, no pressure. Okay. So it depends on what you put in your head and how you and how many movement you impart or give to these ideas, how it will take you to other places. Okay, let's talk about my education. Okay. My dad is a retired school teacher. He taught me first grade. Can you believe that? Amazing. He was a strict teacher. He gave everything for his students. He taught me with great passion. And he was so strict that he taught my sister second grade, and he doesn't allow to get to third grade.
She was in second grade.
She was in grade. She was in grade. Okay. The salary as a teacher is low for the five of us. So he took photos in evenings, on weekends, birthdays, proms, baptisms, and I worked with him and his assistant. Analog cameras, one shot. You cannot say, hey, can you give her the diploma again? Because I didn't know. One shot.
One opportunity.
One opportunity. Animal photography is precious. It's life. Okay. I was a good student. I thought he was going to be a soccer player, a football soccer player. Because a lot of the passion that soccer generated me and also in the Colombian culture. But I had to stop because I wasn't doing well at school. And for my parents, it was very important that I had good grades. Let's talk about my musical influences. This is a fake photo. They never allowed me to touch that studio. Okay, but I found it then. Okay. My musical influences were from classical music. My mom listened to Ravel, Mozart. I'm an operatic one, but I not good. My dad, boleros and salsa, but opera.
Piacere d'amore, più bello il sol non dura. Martire d'amore tutta la vita dura.
But also, in that home in Christopher Columbus, I had Edwin Empire, Michael Jackson, that was awesome. I started late in the arts. When I was 16, I had to do my mandatory military service. Yes, in Colombia it's mandatory. You have to go there. With law, they assigned me to the police. I'm saying with luck because I had the chance to sleep every day at home. Yeah, what point with that? But I had to well with mobility, cars, horse contests, some concerts, logistical support, soccer games. I was tired of doing that. I didn't want to be there. So one time, they asked me, if someone was singing salsa. And I stepped forward and I raised my hand. Yeah, I can sing salsa, yeah. Okay. I have some talent. but maybe a little preparation. That made people from the orchestra bully me for my lack of experience. My experience was so little that I didn't know if I was in tune or not. If I was riding the money and singing with the group or not. So I thought that I need to stop. It was so frustrating. So for a moment, I decided to leave music completely when I finished my mandatory military service. But I was stubborn. And also without having any knowledge in music, I wanted to take the exam to study at the Badger University, and of course, at the defense. But a friend took me to the orchestra of his father, and he said, hey, you got talent, man. You sing well. Okay. And then I wanted to be back to find my initial system. Again, I need to study. So it was a non-profit organization. And, oh, this picture is interesting. That's me singing salsa. The most of places, you know, send the musician to call the people. Okay, but it was great, it was great. I got a scholarship to study in that non-profit organization, and I started studying music with 10 years old children. I didn't feel ashamed about it. I was very happy for the opportunity. And after that, I had a lot of knowledge. I studied a lot, in order to get all that information that gives me like consistency and confidence. After that, I entered to the University of Valle to study, guess what? No, economy. Yay, got it! My parents didn't feel comfortable with the idea of me being a musician. And they told me having like a hobby, like a part-time job, you know? And since I entered to a public university, I was able to enroll in music a year later to see some credits from music. And I started to go into the jazz band playing the congas. That's me playing the congas. like an economist too. Okay, economist, come here, play the congas. Okay. Okay. I spent my time jumping from building to building, from 6 a.m. to 10 p.m. until a teacher told me that it doesn't matter, Mauri, if you're going to live in a small place, if you make less a year than the other, and if you're happy. You know, if you have a mattress and food,
just be happy about it. I see you jumping like that.
Okay. So, and that was revealing. It was revealing. So, my partner took it well because they saw my commitment. And while at the university, I studied acting with a great teacher, Yolanda Garcia. One of the best teachers in Colombia. You remember her? Yeah. From the experimental theater from Cali, Colombia. And he taught me a lot of things. One of those is the success had been seen as a part of the job. That I had to learn that signing autograph is part of the job, you know? And this is one of the tips that keeps you working like with a not forgetting all the things that you have to do in order to get there, you know? And I joined the Grupo Nietzsche. Grupo Nietzsche is a pretty famous band in Colombia and in Latin America. I started to travel the world and finding new inspirations. And when I led that group that is well known, I wanted to make my own songs. And I read a lot of audio, and technicals, manuals, and that. That's how I learned how to speak English. And I didn't have like a teacher or something, you know? That's why I have this. Because you have, in a manual, if you read a manual, do this, do that, do this, do that. It's too boring, you know, to do a speech, and you're trying to do this, trying to do that. Yeah, that's the reason that why I'm trying to put my ideas together in English. This paper. So, while I was developing my project as a solo singer, I set a company between Colombia and the USA, which I made music for the advertising and entertainment industry. I made projects, among other things. Do you remember that tortuguita from Factor X?
Yeah,
I made it. I won a worldwide prize in advertising for doing that. I got my permanent residence status in Colombia for here in the USA, for demonstrating extraordinary abilities in music. Yeah. Here I fell in love and got married. I have two children, one 16, and Isabella, she is 10. And as soon as they gave me my green card, I returned to Colombia. Because I couldn't find my initial system. There in Miami at that time, no YouTube, no, you can, it was practically impossible to develop a career as a singer, you know? So, and I worked at night with the best producer, musical producer, mixing things and singing a little bit more, blah, 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 blah. And in the day I had to put floors. So I said, no, that's not for me. That's not the way. The things are for you, but they push you in order to realize that you're doing something wrong, you know? You're doing something that is not enough, or wise, at least. So, I go to Colombia and start to develop my career, and then came television. Where I was able to participate as an actor in a soap opera of a successful artist called Joe Arroyo. I played Wilson Mayola, the preso. En el mundo que yo vivo, siempre encuentro aquí. Ah, ya, ya. Yep. With that, my image became stronger. And there was able to develop my artistic project in a better way and record songs like Viene y Se Va. It's a song like that has like 8 years. I put it, because it's organic, so I put it in the charts. I didn't put it in the chart. I paid to see in which places it was sounding, and since I put it, like 200 weeks in the top 10 Billboard in Colombia. That's a lot. That's a record. And then Encanto arrives. And after that, yeah, I started doing better in my career. And I came back like 4 years ago. In the middle of the pandemic, I received a knock on casting call I came from an open casting to the Oscars.
That's it. That's it.
And it was amazing because maybe you think when you get married, you get children, and people surrounding you like a family, you will be like achieve your goals late. But actually, they helped me because we had the rule that at home we only need to speak Spanish. You know, in order to give them that heritage, you know. And because Encanto, we start to
talk in English, no?
You need, okay, I will. So we start to talk in English. That's how I learned, and I put all my knowledge into this of the casting call. And for the callback, I was and playing the trombone because I got pretty anxious. And one of the ways for an instrument, so for a musician, wind musician, is to play long notes. If you play long notes, it's a kind of a conscient meditation. You know? That's so why I started. And the reunion started. And I put my trombone there. And when I read the casting callback, they say Jared Bush, Biden Howard, Charis Castro Smith, from Zootopia, Moana, no way!
Oh my God!
So the Zoom meeting started, and Jared said, Hey, you more? Yeah, more. What's that? What? Behind you, that is a trombone. Okay, we have a lot in common. He took his own trombone and showed it to me. That, no way! And that broke the ice in a special and magical way, like Encanto is, because I could be here until tomorrow, telling the story. But, Encanto shows a bigger picture of Colombia and the people from Colombia, the skin tones, the music, taste, food, diversity. And for me, it's like this is the opportunity that I was expecting for, because yeah, I did a couple of successful soap operas, but the prototype of people that get involved in that kind of projects not included, you know? So it was a great chance. I had to take like that, like shooting to the diploma. I got it. So, this is why I am trying to tell you that to survive through these different inertial systems that we know every day, there's only one thing that keeps you alive. It's being yourself. And remember, you are coming from where? You're son of that, and this is the most important thing that you can learn in life. The education, of course. I believe in that. I have a nonprofit organization. I teach music through the internet, and I go to places where the kids maybe don't have enough money to pay for a teacher. And I think this is the responsibilities that we have as entertainers to say how we did it, you know? You can do it, but how? Just a little bit, just say something, no? after the pandemic, we have also this responsibility, I think, a lot more than before, you know? So try to find the way, and I think that in all those new papers that is going out to the street saying that the information is a new form of the material, there's another responsibility to be like honest with us and with the things we share and with the things we get used to use, you know? So, Mauro Castillo, Felix from Encanto, and I'm just to thank
yeah, so now we're going to open the floor for a small Q&A. I'm going to ask a question, then if you see Kate open the floor. If you want to ask a question, you got to stand up, then over here, and then ask it from there, okay? Just because we're in this smaller space, so we really want to hear you, so you guys got to come over here in a line, and then you'll ask your question. So the first question is, what was your first reaction when you read the script from Encanto?
I remember that they didn't give us the whole script. So they just gave me scenes. I didn't know the whole story. So it was really difficult not only to continue casting, but also to record the voices. Mm-hmm. Because they were like, there isn't even the cartoon yet, because they were going to make the cartoon after the voices. So I was in front of nothing, like in front of a mic, and the directors were telling me info about my character and info about kind of the scene and the situation. It was more about situations than scenes. In fact. Mm-hmm. So they were like, now you're pushing a cloud. How do you push a cloud? And you have to do at least 20 takes, at least, of how to push a cloud. I'm like, where's the cloud? Here or here or here? Where? And but then when I had the chance to a little bit kind of understand the story, I was really happy that finally we were going to talk about my country in this way, in this beautiful way, because I know that Colombia, whenever you get told about Colombia, it's so many difficult info that, of course, some of that is real, but we are what we show in Encanto. We are gastronomy, we are diversity, we are music, we are brave women. So I was really happy to be part of this new image that we were going to share with people about my country.
Also with the casting process, this is more a personal aspect, but I started to remember the things what I did like 10 years back with audio, because in the pandemic you cannot hire an engineer. I'm still active doing that, mixing albums, and I have a couple of Grammy nominations, but it was satisfying to think that all the things that you learn in life, like you meet them again later. So it was magical. It was magical to know that I did before some animation, some voices for animation. I understood the language of being a voice actor, but I know about a little bit of lighting because of my shows, my live shows, and all that things helped me to understand that we need to be present here in this moment, learning that we have to learn here and like taking it like a treasure. That's what I learned from the process, because I'm totally with Carolina and all that.
So I'm curious to know what parts of yourselves you saw in Pepa and with Felix.
So I try to control the weather. I can't. But no, it is beautiful because I remember that one of the callbacks, someone was there with me and asked me, how did you feel with that callback? And I was like, I don't know why when I speak English, I feel that people think that I'm crazy. And you were like, what are you talking about? And then they call me and they say, you're gonna be Pepa. And I was like, how's Pepa? She's the craziest of the family. Okay, now I understand everything. Thank you very much. I love Pepa because she's so dramatic, and I am ultra dramatic, I have to admit it. If I don't do anything, my boyfriend is going to stand up here and say, yes, she's ultra dramatic.
Yeah.
So no. But also, it's beautiful about Pepa that we can show these families where parents are still in love with each other, like Pepa and Felix. And also, she's such a maternal woman, she's such an adorable woman. And at the same time, we as a women are so sensitive. And I think it's okay to just allow yourself to feel. And if you are overly dramatic, it's because you're allowing yourself to just show how you feel. And it's fine and it's okay to feel some days down, or feel some days ultra happy, or having all the sensations and feelings at the same time. So I think that's real. And to interpret a real woman from Colombia was beautiful.
Yeah. Felix, with me. Felix is the body. Yeah, Felix is, Felix has a lot of aspect of my personality. He just loves everybody, no matter how much they have, no matter how they are. And it's a very distinct way to talk about the Colombian, right? Actually, there are people from the Pacific and Atlantic Ocean, the way, and in the island also, the way that they receive the tourists, and also the things that they have to deal in life, the lack of opportunities, maybe. I tried I was about a few minutes ago to say it, but when you come from weekend, you have to deal with a lot of situations, and they're so important that you can take your heart apart, you know, take care of your heart, because you cannot transform into a negative person. Can you ask me for
another person? With rewards and I don't know rewards. Yeah, rewards.
No. Como negativo. Negativo. That's like how can you say that?
Negativo.
Yeah.
Pessimistic.
Pessimistic
kind of. I don't know.
When you want to take revenge.
Okay. Yeah. Thank you. Yeah. You're thinking. You have the chance to take revenge, but it will not work at all. We need to understand that we are in this kind of site, in this moment, in this kind of momentums, to really inspire your people, inspire the the one that connects with the history, with the story. So Encanto is a great opportunity to show more about the families. No? Mm-hmm. You don't know how your family knows you, and maybe you don't know enough your family. Felix just loved the people that is surrounding him, and he doesn't care if they have a gift or not. And this is an important part of the time to coexist. This is what I think.
Okay, so never mind everything I said earlier. We're gonna do it from your seats. So if you have a question for them, just raise your hand, and then you can ask it. Does anyone have a question right now? Over there, yes.
I love you guys so much. I love you.
Yeah, for me it was, I didn't understand at the beginning. I was like, it looks like a therapy, but not a casting. But then I understood that what I was saying, that yeah, your gifts are important and your working experience is important as well. But I definitely think that this is really special about Disney, that they really build the characters from who you are. And that was very special for me because I understood that they were looking for human beings behind the characters and behind the actors, mm-hmm. and not only for being ultra successful and being maybe ultra talented. They really wanted to build the story around real people, which was awesome. And that, I think, is why Disney is so great, because it is not just content for kids. It is content for real people, and that really is kind of the reflect of something that is in the moment, what is happening in different parts of the world. It is not only about Encanto, but for example, when you watch Raya, and when you watch different movies from, the Italian one, Luca. It's to learn a little bit more about people from these different parts of the world, but from real people. So at the end of that, I remember that I told my family, and they were like, no, maybe they're not gonna pick you because they didn't want you to sing. I didn't even think that they, but then I understood all this behind, which is maybe why Disney is so big and important in society. Thank you.
Well, if you guys could give Felix a superpower, because he doesn't get one, what would you have?
Yeah. The superpower of Felix is maybe to say a calm down, baby.
That's a huge.
Yeah, it's a huge power. Yeah, I think there's I see twin, you know, and I can see the photos and the forums and they say. Felix is the best husband ever in Disney. So yeah, it's great to know that
Now in Encanto 2, we're gonna know the superpower.
Yeah, they knew it. And we can try to avoid the fact to be like complaining for everything, you know, or try to be reacting about everything. And I think the social media, we're behaving so like selfish, you know, because since you have the camera there, you have to produce yourself in order to have a content like able to be sent to a big wave of things happening, a gazillion of things happening every second. So Felix, he teach how to be less individual and be more part of the group, and this is a superpower.
It is. Yay, I love all these questions!
Yeah.
Hi, I met you both earlier outside, I'm still like...
Yay!
I love you guys. My question is, I know I really love this movie, and my little sister are obsessed with it, and I feel like, I love it so much, it's so nice seeing a diverse family represented. I feel like it represented positive body image, and female empowerment, and just embracing who you are. And that's what really drew me to the movie and makes me love it so much. So my question to you guys is, being diverse individuals too, what did it mean to you to be a part of a project like that, and what kind of impact do you think that makes?
Oh, yeah, it's beautiful to finally feel, as a Colombian and Latina in the United States, that you are important no matter who you are. Where are you from, or the color of your skin, or if you're thin or fat, or however you are, you can be taken in account. You can be part of even a huge project. You can be allowed to share a good message. So, oh my God, yeah, you feel that everything is fair when a movie like Encanto is part of the Disney movies, and I know that sounds a little bit repetitive, but I feel that when you love your country and then you have this awesome image around the world, yeah, to contribute to change that, it was awesome. And it's something else. It is not only about Colombia, and it is not only about Latinos. I think it is about the world, that we're changing our mindset. Finally, we're doing that as a community, a world community. So now we can all be talking with all the courage about being more inclusive in everything we do, and in every content we are sharing to the world, which is awesome.
Okay, let's try to see the business part.
No.
This is important too, because there's a lot of Latinos doing the Encanto movie with this great company of this monster, which is Disney Animation Studios, and this is a transnational and a huge this is a huge achievement in Encanto worldwide, selling millions and millions of dollars. So it brings a lot of hope to the artists of any minority that are dreaming about to communicate about their towns, you know. And the narrative is changing, and this is very grateful to see productions like that, like Encanto, like this one, and selling well. A minority starring the movie with a story that involves all of us, but Latinos, you know, but made by Latinos. So this is important because this brings a lot of hope. I went to Telemundo like 3 weeks ago, releasing my new song, Sa Cha Cha Cha. Let's go the cha cha cha. Go hit the floor and be a cha cha queen. I wanna see you dance, 1, 2, cha cha cha. Uno, dos, bailemos, amor. Shake them all, baby, come on. Okay, this is the I went there because in Telemundo you can find Dominicans, you can find people from here, actually, of course. But Peruvians, Central Americans, and all of those were like, wow, this is amazing to be here. You can feel the love and you can feel the hope that Encanto means. Yeah, because they are in the industry, you know, they're involved in that and they know how difficult it is to develop a content and put it in a successful way to the world. So I think it's a huge portal that is opening right now for all the person that dreams about just to do things and communicate. Huh? I repeat that I came from an open casting. This is amazing. This is showing that there's like clean paths nowadays. Okay, that's I had to say it. Yeah. My neighbors was hired by a company, X company. The whole block changed. Hey man, this man, he's working from, I don't know, Microsoft. Yeah, he's working from Microsoft. Yeah, I mean, I want to be like that. I want to be like here. This is huge, and I believe in the education and the power that it has to transform life. So congratulations, huh? And I think it's not easy to be here, but you will help a lot of people around you.
And I know that your family must be super proud of you.
Yeah, sure. To all of you. No. Yeah, you could live maybe a few blocks away, but that's not easy. Yeah. We're feeling so proud being here with you guys.
Yeah.
I'm speaking on behalf of my sister.
Hi!
She loves you guys a lot. She's a super fan. She doesn't have a question, but she wanted me to tell you guys that she performed a whole play of Encanto with her friend. She wants me to shout out Mauricio Castillo.
Wow!
You like.
life-changing moment, not only for us, but yeah, for I think definitely for all of us that have the chance to live this story. I think a lot. I think things have changed a lot. In my case, wow, to perform at the Oscars.
Things. this is why, this is because that sometimes the most irresponsible thing that you can do is make a plan. You know, yeah. The pandemic taught me that. So it's more about the, it's more about your center of your essence of your soul, and the thing that you are, that you, the thing that you think of, are you prepared for, or are you preparing for? We need to focus on that, because I think we get lost trying to see the lights and, oh, yeah, yeah, see, we need to go do the lights. And I've been here, not at this scale, but I've been here in, this, in a moment of success, and I always been trying to be calm and to stay calm to see the next change, to stay showing more about the culture, more about your essence. And I think this is important. Maybe to have a plan is not the best thing. There's a lot of projects coming and scripts, fortunately, and music and tours. I'll be in Miami, Washington, Los Angeles, maybe New York, in Colombia too. We'll be in Cartagena, like next month, right? Yeah, there's a lot of things happening, but we need to stay focused and try to do things, everything more, every time more honest, in an honest way. I think that's the call. I'm doing this exercise. Oh, this is great. I teach this to my students. I try to breathe, but you know, this is like a balloon, no? You get in and you expand and blow and you contract. But try to be the same person taking the air in and out. You know, so you take the air. And you blow up and you stop and you're still being the same form, in the same form. That helps a lot, emotionally and physically. And that, and there's a thing that I had to learn this sleep without my cell phone in the bed or around, all right? So I start doing it, and I'm sleeping better because the pandemic wasn't easy for any of us, and we are trying to get like nothing happened before now, but we're trying to continue our path, like trying to forget it. No, we have to learn to talk with ourselves. And that's a good way. Try to breathe and do that, and try to be kind with you, and that's what I'm trying to do. Okay, I think I'm doing better every day doing that. Okay, so this is my advice. I don't know, Pepa, what you have to say?
Because Pepa would be quiet. Allow yourself to. Right. I think that the struggles would be the awards that you're gonna get after. And there's no struggle without something really good that is coming after that. Definitely. And when you're struggling, it's because you're doing something extra. Something that is difficult for you. And I definitely think that people that try even harder than they think they can definitely are such a brave people. And it's awesome to feel after that you did that and that you were brave, and now you can tell that story. So you're gonna make it. Just
Walk
a little bit.
You're capable.
One more.
Yeah,
we're
fine. I think in the pink. Hi,
last question.
I love you both and your characters. Your line comes with line, which he says, clear sky, clear sky. I always say that to myself.
Me too.
I recorded 8 months. 8 months of me recording Felix, and when I saw him, I was like, wow. He's like, that's my boy. Like Felix, says to Antonio, oh, there you are. So.
I was crying like crazy. I remember the first time they even showed me a scene, not even the whole movie, but just the scene where she was singing "We Don't Talk About Bruno." I was crying like crazy, and the directors were like, "Okay, it's just a scene." But it's so exciting! It's so exciting that you are there, not because how you look. Because I was used to be like performing with my entire body. But then you were performing with your entire body, but it wasn't about it. It was about what you communicate through your voice. Mm-hmm. And the superpower was through your voice to give life to such a good and important message. So, and she was so different than me, but at the same time, like in the physical, but at the same time I was like, okay, now I can feel like in her eyes, my look. And I started seeing those kind of little details in the character that were exactly like I would do things, and I would look and I would hold my baby or whatever. I was like, oh my God, they really found that in me. So it was really exciting. I cannot stop crying. Maybe I can start right now, so stop crying.
Yeah, it was amazing. So, right before the premiere, I have the chance to talk with a journalist from Germany, but she lived in LA, like 30 years living in LA. And she said, there's apples in Colombia? She said, yeah. And with that question, I realized that we are apparently connected. We're trying to measure everything, but the numbers is not enough. Huh? Big data and all that stuff. And it's a great chance to show more about that 5 million of Afro-Colombians that recognize at least. But I thought this is huge. This is a great chance to discover more worlds like this one, and to be discovered by the Encanto lovers. So this is one of the most important things that I learned from the process of seeing Felix and being about to release the movie. You know?
Umbrella.